So I'm gonna tell you. Yeah, I'm gonna tell you stories of miracles. But I'm just gonna tell you this though. Spiritual stuff, you know, like spiritual depths, is very they are very hard to explain. So if somebody claimed that they could clearly explain everything to you, and very eloquently, make them demonstrate their faith, because. You know, because the truth is really complex, I'm telling you. That's the point, because God said, my ways are higher than your ways, my thoughts are higher than your thoughts. And he also said, my ways are not your ways, and my thoughts are not your thoughts. In other words, there's a huge difference between how God thinks and how we think. You know, so if we use our ordinary human logic to try to perceive God, and even to try to judge him, you know, it's only going to backfire, I'm telling you, because God is infinite. Yeah, humans are finite, but God is infinite. So when I said I'm infinite, I'm not saying that I, as a human being, is infinite. I'm saying that God within me is infinite. So you know what it looks like, okay? Yeah. So can we, go to 1 Kings chapter 16. Chapter 17. Chapter 17, it says, you can read yourselves, right? You can read for yourselves, right? Okay, so, and as she was going to fetch it, he called to her and said, bring me, I pray thee, a morsel of bread in thine hand. Okay, and she said, as the Lord thy God liveth, I have not a cake, but an handful of meal in a barrel, and a little oil in a cruse. And behold, I'm gathering two sticks that I may go in and dress it for me and my son, that we may eat it and die. Okay, so she was like, this is the last of what I have, you know, I don't even have enough for myself. How could I feed you, prophet, man of God? Okay, and Elijah said unto her, fear not, go and do as thou hast said, but make me thereof a little cake first, and bring it unto me, and after make for thee and for thy son. For thus saith the Lord God of Israel, the barrel of meal shall not waste, neither shall the cruse of oil fail, until the day that the Lord sendeth rain upon the earth. And she went and did according to the saying of Elijah, and he and her house did eat many days, and the barrel of meal wasted not, neither did the cruse of oil fail, according to the word of the Lord which he spake by Elijah. First of all, the widow had enough faith to do charity with what little money she had left. She had scarce resources, but she decided to give the remainder of her resources to the man of God, to the prophet. I know this is going to defy all kinds of modern explanations, because you know as well as I do, people like to keep their money. They don't want to share it with anyone. And you tell me you're going to give the last of your resources to the man of God. Oh, that's a cult. It's a cult. We're going to stop that person. We're going to stop that freak. We're going to stop that scam artist. But you know what? She did it. And then she was rewarded with prosperity. It's true. And this also is what Elisha multiplies the widow's oil. That's Elisha. With a double portion of Elijah's anointing. Both were prophets, men of God. Yeah? So, now there cried a certain woman of the wives of the sons of the prophets unto Elisha, saying, thy servant, my husband, is dead, and thou knowest that thy servant did fear the Lord, and the creditor is come to take unto him my two sons to be bondmen. And Elisha said unto her, what shall I do for thee? Tell me, what hast thou in the house? And she said, thine handmaid hath not anything in the house save a pot of oil. Then he said, go, borrow thee vessels abroad of all thy neighbours, even empty vessels, borrow not a few. And when thou art come in, thou shalt shut the door upon thee and upon thy sons, and shalt pour out into all those vessels, and thou shalt set aside that which is full. So she went from him, and shut the door upon her and upon her sons, and who brought the vessels to her, and she poured out. And it came to pass, when the vessels were full, that she said unto her son, bring me yet a vessel. And he said unto her, there's not a vessel more, and the oil stayed. Then she came and told the man of God, and he said, go sell the oil and pay thy debt, and live thou and thy children after rest. Okay, so Elijah also worked a prosperity miracle, okay? And he saved the widow. He saved the widow. The widow, you know what? This kind of miracle also existed in Buddhist stories. Do you know that? Oh, you don't know that, do you? Look. 我轉台啦，係啊，真係我而家成日都要轉台，因為又中又英咁樣。你香港咧，你知香港咩㗎？香港 multilingual 咁啊，而家三種語言㗎嘛。以前就淨係得廣東話同埋英文，跟住最近又加咗普通話啦，係咪先？你唔好叫我講普通話，真係我話我上到大陸先算啦，係咪先？佢呢度話咩咧？啊，梵志曉佛。我有啲字咧唔係好識讀個中文，你知唔知啊？真係噶，佢話佢翻屋企攞咗個缽啦，係咪先？係缽啊，嗬？係咪缽啊？其中盛滿了蜜，兩手擎住，恭敬供養如來，即係如來佛祖啦，係咪？佛陀告訴諸比丘，諸比丘，其實老實講啊，即係而家冇人會供養啲咩神職人員嗰啲嘅，你和尚要化緣都唔知點化添啊！而家真係，取此缽物，布施給眾僧。奇怪的是，這一小缽物供養了佛及眾僧，使大眾都得到滿足後，缽中的物居然還是滿滿的，沒有減少。咦？耶穌基督都有做過啲咁嘅神蹟啊，知唔知啊？所以你話啲佛教徒點解唔信咧？佢話：，切，我哋夠有啦，係咪先？咁你話點算咧？係咪先？係咪？啊，繼續講埋落去啦，係咪？凡智不知如何是好。又奉上給佛陀，佛陀就告訴梵志：你取此物投入大水無量之流，水中從這個我又不記得是什麼字，如果有個中文老師教我你話幾好呢，但我媽就肯定咩我啦，我睇埋曬啲佛教書，睇埋曬啲咁怪嘅書，又神通又成啊嘛，係啊，所以我唔咩啦。今日本來話你翻教會啦，我話你千祈唔好翻立亂翻教會，話你知，即係好似你唔好入立，即係唔好立亂去拜神一樣啊，即係你唔好入。不要入啲陰廟嗰啲，你之前有冇有聽講過？即係有冇睇過啲咩關於東南亞嗰啲書咧？咪話會中降嗰啲嘢，咪有啲陰廟嘅，好似泰國裏邊啊，即係有啲東南亞嗰啲地方嘅泰國啦，馬來西亞嗰啲地方咧，唔知邊度有陰廟啊嘛？中國都係嘅，你唔好話我種族歧視喎，周圍都係嘅喎。我話咧，你亂咁入啲教會咧，你以為教會好正氣嘅，冇嘢嘅。點都冇嘢，唔係嘅，教會都可以有邪靈嘅話你知，即係如果你去錯地方咧，佢哋就揦嘢㗎啦，就即係揦屎上身咁樣，知唔知啊？真係㗎，我都話，即係我媽逼我翻教會嚟睇下佢個 spirit 咁 oppressive， 都知唔係好嘢啦，係咪先？我同我遲啲解釋下點解喎？嗰個你阿媽阿爸嚟㗎，我話咁阿媽阿爸咁啊點啫，係咪先？係咪我阿媽阿爸就一定係完美嘅冇邪靈咧，係咪先？我自己仔女都可能有邪靈啦，係咪？即係你咁講係咪？即係要即係至少要公平少少係咪？即係公正少少。啲人係嘅，即係你話啲人如果有咩陰陽眼嗰啲咩天眼嗰啲，我是但啦。陰陽眼淨係睇鬼嘅啫，天眼就乜都睇嘅。天眼應該係公平公正噶嘛，唔會話因為你同佢親啊，佢就一定冇事，一定冇鬼係咪先？咁唔係啊嘛，睇係咁嘅啦咪。即係如別咁樣，係咯，即係啲龜嗰啲嘢，如別嗰啲，將把那缽物色蒙其味咁啊。梵志受教之後，就將物投入水中，還至佛所。嚇、啊！最後尾咧，唔單止餵人啊，最後仲餵埋啲水族生物咧，啲水生動物啊，即係佢哋咁樣講啊。之前咪有本書咧，係佛教徒點樣去，即係係佛教徒寫噶嘛，係批評基督教噶嘛，真係有呢本書嘅話，你知喺中央圖書館我以前有睇過嘅。佢喺度話啊，如果呢個耶穌呢、這個所謂耶穌基督真係佛嘅話，佢一定係一個笨佛啦咁樣寫噶嘛。佢就話嚇講埋曬啲咁嘅比喻，係咁拆件。佢話我哋夠有啲咁嘅故事啦，係咪先？我哋仲勁啦，係咪先？我哋仲耶啦，係咪？你自己睇下我哋啲經典係咪仲好？我話咁你點啊？係咪先？咁咪就係咯，即係要尋求答案咧，要尋求答案咧，我睇怕咧一定要復古先得啦。老實講，真係嘅，因為人哋都有神蹟，人哋都有故事啦，人哋都有歷史噶嘛，係咪？你以為你大曬咩？係咪先？而家啲現代啲基督徒真係以為自己大曬嘅話，你知我話未必真係大曬嘅，係咪先？我咪就話等我揾到答案，咪話翻俾你知啦，係咪先？我都～ 我都未即係我都未完全地睇到成即係成幅圖畫係咪先？即係話誒，你獻張圖俾皇帝啦咁樣，即係畫張圖俾皇帝。我話誒、我而家畫緊㗎啦，係咪先？我而家喺度畫緊，即係好似例如咩《山海經》嗰啲咩，即係畫嗰啲地誒、畫啲地勢圖啊，即係嗰啲 3D 地勢圖啊。喂，大佬，我都未行完係咪？我都未行完中國，我點畫曬俾你睇啊？係咪先？我話我未行完喎，係咪？你咁快就催我要我畫曬成幅地圖獻俾你係咪？咁我如果畫錯點算先係咪先？咁你應該俾我繼續去，即係你俾我繼續去探險，直至到我睇曬成個中國，然後跟住我就畫翻張圖俾你啊嘛，係咪先？即係你話咁樣啱唔啱係咪？合唔合理啦係咪？你認唔認同啦係咪先？唔得啦，嚇、啊！你看這個凡，你這個凡字以物供佛，布施比丘僧，如物投於水中供養。這個凡字在接下來世的二十劫中，將不會墮惡趣。再過二十劫，當得圓覺，果為名為物具。啊、記得要布施埋啲動物咧，即係唔好話啲動物冇性嗰啲嘢啊！即係我媽之前係咁話啲動物冇性嘅。即係我覺得佢就係點樣？你揀我哋揀啲動物啊，成日都係咁啊！你揀我哋揀揀你嘅信仰啊！你揀我哋係揀佢啊！你揀我定揀你阿爸啊！即係好，即係我唔覺得好好忌邪嘅，唔知你覺得唔係忌邪嘅，即係唔係忌邪？即係我覺得佢好，我唔知點講，好似成日都要我揀佢咁樣喎。咁我點解要成日都揀你先？即係我就咁問我點解要我成日都揀你先？咁喂。咁大佬，佢知佢仲話你揀自己定揀我先，即係基本上佢要成為我心目中裏邊最大粒嗰樣嘢，你明唔明啊？即係一個其實基本上佢係一個偶像嚟嘅喎，即係話你父母都可以成為你嘅偶像，你知唔知啊？而家真係嘅，而家我真係唔係覺得係偶像嚟咯，即係話唔可以有任何嘢取替到我喺你心目中嘅地位，我先係最大嘅咁樣啊！即係佢其實已經係想取代耶穌嘅，你知唔知啊？你自己睇下係咪？我你睇下我阿媽係咪咁講係咪先？你諗下佢心態係咪咁樣啊？佢個心態就係咁樣啦。你到底即係乜嘢都係要我揀佢嘅，以我阿媽為先嘅話，喂大佬你諗下咪你諗下先。即係你個仔女，如果你有幸有一個女係可以修成正果，係真係可以做到身體同靈魂都永生不死嘅，即係可以咁樣做嘅。如果真係可以 literally， 咁我問你。你係咪應該要替鄧，即係你係咪應該要替鄧你個女高興咧？係咪先？即係終於都有一個人可以收成正果啦！話喂，咁你放手啦，係咪先？就嚇、啊、你要供養我咁咯。我話如果我即係如果調翻轉咧，即係話嚇你調翻轉，你覺得點啊？你未生個女，你唔知啊；你未生個仔，你唔知啊。我話啦，你信唔信我？就算生咗，我都會係咁樣嘅心態。即係你信唔信我會係好偉大咁？我話你唔使供我啦，你有得我乜嘢？你自己去。承受永生啦，即系我话一系咧，我就同你一齐承受永生，系咪？一系就你自己一个承受永生，系咪？我点可以咁样拖累、咁样就助自己个仔女嘅啫？咁系好唔啱嘅行为嚟嘅，系咪先？即系真系唔啱啊！你自己话啦，客观评下你系咪唔啱先？系咪？即系你点可以咁样阻住你仔女？你仔女如果真系修成正果，你应该戥佢高兴先系嘅，唔系系咁踩佢，系咁绑住佢，唔俾佢乜嘢？我話：喂，我到老來我都放手啦，係咪啊？即係老實講，我都聽天由命啦，係咪啊？即係我自己都會係咁樣嘅喎，我真係會係咁樣，你信唔信先？你明唔信先？喂，咁你做俾我睇咯，我話。喂，咁但係老實講啊，即係如果我真係要做嘅話，咁即係我冇得手獨身啦，係咪先？我冇得手獨身，咁即係我要放棄永生啦，係咪先？喂，咁唔咩噶嘛，係咪先？咁咪就係咁講咯，啊，自己睇啊，自己睇。唯言世尊，為什麼這個凡字會因一撥物而得到如此多嘅利益呢？咁樣，這個凡字非但今世一撥物多所曉益，前世宿命也是如此。在很久很久的過去世之前，有一個婆羅門，自己住在閒居寂寞之處。非常喜歡供養仙人，啊！而家邊有人供養仙人咧？都唔信有仙添嘅。而家邊説信有人修仙嘅？係咪？點會供養你啊？係咪？不過我都唔想人哋供養，因為如果人哋供養我咧，我覺得佢哋會控制我，就令到我冇辦法修成正果嘅啦。當時有一個仙人得五神通， 見此婆羅門心之所念，就在樹下閒居之處，擁身空中，安住在他人面前。婆羅門看見後，歡喜踴躍，係咪咧？好似係啊！善心生起，即歸還家中，盛了滿缽的物，敬奉仙人。當時仙人接受此供養，飛在虛空。婆羅門由於此布施的功德，後來作了國王，名叫密具，以正法治國。壽終之後，得生天上。佢結果都係你睇下，佢蜜糖嚟噶，蜜糖係有糖分啊，係有 sugar 嘅，點可以叫人哋戒糖嘅啫？你知唔知道點解要用？你哋知唔知道點解要用蜜糖嚟供養神仙啊？即係點解要供養？點解要用蜜糖供養仙人咧？因為仙人係食素嘅。仙人食素，佢仲要唔食五谷呢？其實佢唔可以冇糖分嘅，佢一定要有。